what Palantir does is it allows AI to be useful for companies.
Tell us more about what Palantir does as a company exactly.
So this is where, Lacey, I was getting into the fact that it is a hard company necessarily to understand. I think one of the easiest ways for me to talk about this is to talk about this in terms of their relevance with what's going on with AI, okay? So all of us here are familiar with the concept of a large language model, and that's what a lot of businesses are using to run AI applications. LLMs, as they're known, are somewhat commoditized in that regard. And what Palantir offers, they do have their own proprietary LLM. Okay, let's just say that. But they also offer platforms such as their Foundry and Gotham, which provide the infrastructure that allow LLMs to work to give businesses meaningful insights to make their decisions. I'm not going to use the language that maybe as colorfully as Alex Karp uses, but what basically it does is it takes AI from being just kind of a box that a company checks and says, yes, we have AI functionality, but it doesn't really do much, to something where AI is giving these companies meaningful data that drives the solutions. A good analogy, Lacey, that I heard, this isn't mine, so I can't take credit for it. Actually, I'll give credit to, I think her name is Haley Eich, who does a podcast basically exclusively about Palantir. So if you think about LLMs, LLMs are kind of like a car. And what Palantir is doing with Foundry and Gotham and such is designing the bridges and the roads that the car can run on to make the car actually kind of useful. And that's what Alex Karp uses that word a lot in terms of saying, what Palantir does is it allows AI to be useful for companies, and they're certainly figuring that out. And again, to all investors out there, I just gave you a 5-minute layman's description of this. You need to do your own due diligence.